So here Chef Shiva is making some homemade pastas. Let's learn from him what he's making and he'll teach us some different shape of pastas. So over to Chef Shiva. Hi Chef.
Hello guys. So if you remember last time we saw how to make a pasta dough. So now we are going to show you how to make different shapes of stuffed pastas. So starting from ravioli, your tortellini or cappelletti, your tibetti and agnolotti. So there are a lot of different kinds of shapes. So I'll go ahead and maybe show one by one.
Sure, Chef. So let's start.
So first thing we are going to do is tortellini.
Okay, so the good thing is Chef Shiva has already sheeted and kept the cut shape for us. So he'll... So first, what are you making, Chef Shiva?
First I'm making tortellini.
Tortellini.
Yeah. So we're going to make sure... So tortellini is a small stuffed pasta. Okay.
So Chef Shiva, you have used water to stick.
Water to stick.
And if you notice, Chef Shiva is pressing the corners, the edges, so that the thickness is again back to the same. And it's very important to press so that when you are blanching, the edges, the joints all get cooked equally from everywhere.
So here we go, tortellini. And the next pasta we are gonna go is tortelloni.
So the first was tortellini and now he is making tortelloni. The difference is size, right, Chef?
Yes. So generally if you see tortellini, it's ravioli made of meat stuffing and it generally goes in the broth. So
okay.
It's generally it's like a soup garnish. So they put it in the broth and they just have it like a soup.
So it's very important for us to make small pastas for soup because it should come in the spoon.
In one spoon.
In one spoon. That's very, very important. So if you see, I'll just hold Chef Shiva. So what he has done... He has taken the round shape stuff and then turn it over and made a half moon. And if you see now, he's folding it towards inside, pressed it, joint, and press the joint very, very stiffly so that it come back to the same thickness. And our tortelloni and tortellini both are ready. Okay. So the next you are showing is cappelletti.
So next we are going to go cappelletti.
Cappelletti. In cappelletti, he is using a square shape.
You can use both, but square you can actually see the hat shape.
Yeah.
So generally cappelletti is like hat.
And he has folded from the sides, and so this time we have made a triangle, not a half moon.
Yeah. So made into a triangle, and then folded inside.
And if you once this is there, you'll see a very nice.
So it looks like a hat.
Yeah.
And then next we are going to go is agnolotti. So agnolotti generally is, you can take a long sheet.
Some people use egg also for joining, but we use water. It just ensures that your edges get cooked faster.
So agnolotti is basically like a pillow shaped pasta.
You can use any stuffing, whatever you want.
Yes, but for agnolotti it should be like a creamy stuffing, but when you pinch, it should not damage the pasta dough. And then it will have a small flip. Okay, so this is agnolotti. And there is a different, similar pasta like this from a region called Friuli, which is the pasta name called Slicofi. So, The making of the rava is exactly the same as agnoti, but the pinching would be a little different.
So right now you are using Parmesan fondue?
It's a burrata mixture, burrata cheese. Okay, so because of Tatuni we're pinching like this, for this we'll pinch like this.
And what name you mentioned, chef?
It's called Slikofi. Yeah.
And which region this is from?
Generally it's made with potatoes, it's from a region, Fruni. This is your agnoti, this is your Slikofi.
Excellent, chef.
Okay, and then next pasta we are going to go is Fagottini. So Fagottini is generally a pasta like a bouquet, like a package, purse.
So it's like a pouch, money bag.
Like a money bag. Okay, that's a Fagottini.
Fagottini.
Yes. And the next I'm going to do a Tibetti. So Tibetti is basically a tube-shaped pasta. So we take a little longer rectangle sheet and then into the filling. Okay, so this is Tibetti pasta. Okay, now so next we'll go mesolini. So mesolini is nothing but it's a half moon shaped pasta. Then we make a pinch with a fork. So this is called mesolini. Okay, next we are going to make mesolini. It's same as like Mesolini. Like I said, mesolini is a half moon. This is like a triangle shaped pasta. You take a square sheet. Same way you can seal the sides with water. Here we go, mesolini.
there's one more shape which is a, it's a ravioli but different shape of like a pyramid. So you can take a square sheet.
This is a very nice shape.
You join all the four corners together. Keep it together, four corners together, and then press it together. Okay, so this is like a pyramid. Okay, and the normal ravioli which we make, a square ravioli.
These are different shapes of raviolis. You can make square.
So one is also a cap shaped ravioli where you put a stuffing and then you fold the sides. So all these are variations after the standard classical shapes. You can play around with your shapes based on your presentation. So you just fold, press. Fold, press, fold, press, fold, press, and then you take another round, small size. The first one was a big, then you take the smaller size, you press on top, press nicely. And then with the cutter, so you get a nice standing hatch. Also, we can make tortellini with the. So then, once you have learned the art, then you can do as many shapes as you want. So, thanks Shiva.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. And in the next video, next time we'll show you how to cook the pasta, yeah, how to make different sauces, and how to play around. So, thank you. Over and out. Have a nice evening. Enjoy Sunday.